And as usual though, however, that always have to be just along with the teammates. So let's see right here. Paravasis. Nope. But apparently we're going to be playing through Mecha Mosh again, so this is the minigame we've already played through since the previous board in Bob Bomb Factory, so let's go ahead and do that again. But this time, just teaming up with a female, known as, well, obviously, Princess Daisy, so, yeah. And hopefully, though, I should be able to just, god, I messed that up. But at least we're still going to catch up to him, though. Come on, gone. Gotcha! Alright, so this will actually make me come back into these mini stars count right now. But not for long though, because until at the very end, there's gonna be more bunch of boos all the way to the end. So we'll just have to worry about that for right now. But yeah, at least we just went past for that poltergeist boo. Or the poor portrayed that right there. Sorry, my lips are just a little bit tiresome. Anyway, come on. Ah, oh, darn it. Somehow I lost 5 mini stars, and plus I might lost half of the mini stars once again. Well, at least I might get a dice block though, at least. But somehow my mini stars will actually become gone again. Boy, that's a bit underwhelming. 16. Jesus, 16. Oh yeah, by the way, whilst these other opponents did actually get legs by Boo, because that's usually part of their damage on them, then basically that means the Boos will just fly away instead of just like just stay put in all the, at all times. So at least we got those. So yeah. And right now, I was in 4th place right now, so I'm not a big fan of, like, I was being 4th place right now. But maybe one day at the end, I will able to catch up, though, at least. Okay, so spin. Luigi's about to be scared. 1 through 10 dice blocks, so, hey, at least he got that item. Somehow my heart just starts to be beaten right now, it's because, sometimes that, well, I always get lost those mini stars by Boos. What a strange looking tower. You should go check it out. Captain Event! So let's see what we have this time around. Let's see if we can go through the portal right there. There's not much around here besides, you know, spaces. And hey! Why do you steal our mini stars, you thieving rat? Oh no, the scouty rat ran off with your mini stars. You gotta catch the scouty rat to get your mini stars back. You wanna hear about the scouty rat's race? Yep. You must catch the scouty rat to receive all of your mini stars. The shattered rat will use the 1, 2, 3 dice block to try to escape, while you give chasing using the regular dice block. Whoever catches the thief gets all the mini stars. The captain should consider how far away the shattered scouty rat is before. Well, it's too late to start just saying his final speech. Of course, the CPU wants to make me go first. So what the hell, man? So he was 7 away, so I need to get the dash base, so yeah, once you land on those, you should be able to progress through the thing itself. It's a bit similar to the 9 island that we actually played through. Oh, come on! God dang. We're so close. Alright, let's see what Waluigi's about to get. He's about to get just 2. So I'm assuming he's gonna get just green spaces. There are some green spaces involved here and there, and some of them has dash spaces, so dash spaces are always helpful for you. Especially noticeable in this event. Alright, let's see what Daisy's gonna get. She's about to get 3. And now it's time for Luigi's time to shine. So I'm assuming that he's now 4 away. And I can probably guess by now, he's probably gonna get it. Yep, he's got it. Thanks to that sick number he's got. And once you got, once you stomp on him, then you get some mini stars back. I think the only maximum is only 8 because Shaggy Rat only steals like 2 mini stars, and that's about it. Well, I'm just gonna just use that at least to actually just to keep myself safe, at least for now. So I don't want to get my higher rolls or anything, like the 6, for example. And it looks like we're almost there, so because I see that was a little checkpoint flag. But we have 3-4 minigames to deal with, so let's see what minigame we have to play through. Tumble Temple. Dodge the spiked balls as they roll down the ramp, beat the last player standing to win. Hold the Wii remote sideways, press D-pad to move, and 2 to jump. So it's basically just a last player's last one standing is the winner, just so that we actually have to dodge those spike balls with a Pachinko type of wizard, or Pachinko some sort of gimmick. So far so good that Daisy's in last place at least. So I guess I just want to briefly mention this about something, is that only 3 more days until when Mario Tennis Ultra Smash is about to come out. Even then, a lot of people seem to get disappointed how the board themes doesn't usually mesh well. Like, it's usually just the exact same environment, but just with different pattern to it. Oh yeah, this is what this minigame starts to get a bit chaotic. As soon as when we pass through the 30 seconds, the more spike balls he actually gets. Like, there was like a bunch of them. And plus the Pachinko ramp just somehow make it acting crazy. So, you know. Alright, I think I should be able to get some of these mini stars at least. Although, not so much for this, though. Alright then, Luigi's time. And it looks like we have to deal with another minigame to handle with. Still with Hammer Brother. But occasionally, sometimes he'll eventually send out the Fire Bros, which I'll explain to that when we actually just about to encounter with him. Jigsaw Jumbo, I think this is the minigame we've played before, so hopefully though, I should be able to be fast this time. Just so that I want to just to get my, well, new record. I got that, no problem. And also got, this one. Oh, I managed to place the wrong piece in there. I guess I just managed to place that wrong piece there. Oh well. Alright, so far so good on the 4th one, and let's see if I can get this in the 5th part. Okay, there we go. So I got 21 seconds and 93 milliseconds, so I think I beat myself the previous record. So you know what that means, folks? New record! I believe from that, you know, when Mario Party 10 does not have a new record type of minigames, well, at least only one counts in during the jewel drop from that puzzle game of any sorts. But I suppose from this point onwards that until Mario Party 10, that in Mario Party 10 does not have a announcement like a announcer like start, finish, new record, or stuff like that. Well, thank you, Green Toad, for actually giving me a slow dice block after when I get caught by these boots bunch of concealing times. But, at least thank you for actually giving me that item, though. Alright, so we got about 4 Bowser spaces this time around, unlike the previous 4 that we actually got around, like, 6 of these Bowser spaces. And if you probably can tell already, oh, Daisy actually got 3 mini stars, so lucky her. But somehow we have to deal with these 2 Boo Poltergusts, or portraits now, so we have to worry about those now. So I'm hoping I'm not gonna lose any of these at all. Right, I'll stick with 5 from this slow dice block, so just in case with my save. Well, at least if I subtract my 5 mini stars for that point. and I'll just simply just go up there and get those 10 mini stars at least. Right. Things all have been good to be like everything's all in fine, like me and Waluigi are in third place right now. Not so much like Wii Party in the Board Game Island. If you see right there, there's actually a number that's been related has been stayed in put when there was a wall just blocking your path. Like, you have to get like 6 in order to actually do this for the first try. But if you somehow made it wrong, the only difference has been is that rather than just actually letting the number change, well, at least in the when you actually come across into the spiked ball part, that somehow the number is actually decreasing from 2 to like, well, 6 will actually decrease now into 4, so at least we got that, at least, for that little change. I believe this also same applies to the whimsical waters in Mario Party 10, when you come across into the circular part. So, yeah, I think that's all I want to know about, so yeah. I believe, fundamentally, when you actually go into this part right here, they're all just the exact same when you're actually trying to go ahead and trying to grab those 10 mini stars, but as far as the length of the paths goes, the up route will actually be the shortest, and then the left one will have to be the longest. So, yeah, that makes a difference. Alright, let's see what we got. I'm guessing that the boos are actually always had to be on the little square part, rather than they actually not supposed to go onto this gate, because, well, couldn't be bothered to go through the gates, for some armadillo reason. And it looks like, gave minis 5 mini stars to the last place player. I wonder who is that going to be at. Oh! Thank you. Thank you, Bowser, for actually giving me, let Daisy just to, give me those 5 mini stars. So, thank you, Bowser. I'll give you worth credit. Alright. So, I think I should able to get, like, even then I'm still a little bit, way far behind with this right now. But, I'm more worried about if I get backspace, I should able to get screwed myself. Ah, shoot, I forgot to use that item. God dang it. Well, if only if I use my item, well, don't know what to say. I think I lost all of my mini stars for this right now, so even though it makes it much more worse than that, I might get caught by a boo twice. Not one, but 2. So, I'm guessing that the other opponents do not get caught by a boo at all, but I guess I'm the only one get caught by the boo. Like, even though at the beginning part I didn't get caught at all, but I somehow get caught by boo 4 times. Now that was incredibly ridiculous right there. Stupid backspace. Ah, whatever. At least I might just gonna have to, like, do it worth it, I suppose. Anyway, so we play Polo Extreme, so we'll play Pianta Pool in the later times. So let's go ahead and do Own It. Choose the image with the pattern that matches on the one on the spinning urn. The faster you choose the correct image, the more points you receive. Hold the Wiimote vertically, point at the image you want to select, and press A to confirm your choice. So, it's basically just a guessing which type of part patterns you actually need to press on. So, yeah, let's go ahead and do that. Round 1. I'm guessing it's this one on the left. And I'm guessing the other players are actually going to be choosing the same part as I was going to, so, yeah. Because of that though, you know, I'm usually selecting those computer opponents on hard difficulty this time around, so, you know, I should do that more often now, so, you know. Alright, so looks like we're doing pretty well so far. Oh yeah, I completely forgot, we're actually doing a battle minigame for that point anyway, so anyway. And since I was a last place player, then I just usually select this minigame at least, so you know. And I think that's, Onets, it's actually pretty simple.
Finish!
It usually takes place during the, some little, parts galleries, as far as these different patterns is concerned, so, yeah. Everything's all in check here. I don't know why I kept on saying that, it's all in check though. Okay, so my only thing I need to worry about is both Daisy and Luigi, because Luigi's in first place, and I'm assuming that, well, Daisy might actually just about to go ahead and just grab those some of those mini stars, the remaining ones, I believe, but I digress. Alright, so we have another Bowser event here, I guess, so what event should we have to deal with this time? Battle of half of the mini stars. Okay, let's go ahead and do that. And hopefully, if I was going to win, then I should able to manage to claim those mini stars, and hopefully, I should just catch up. So yeah, 62 mini stars, and the first place player will receive 31. So anyways, so we played those two mini games, but Goomba Village though, not exactly sure. I do know I will play this in another time, but for now, let's go ahead and do a twist ending. So, even now, this is the minigame we've already played. So, yeah, I might go ahead and do that, just to make it easier for me. Start. I will do that minigame in another board at some point, but right now, it's just that I couldn't help it if I was going to actually get lost by those stupid boos. They're actually trying to making me just to lose the half of the mini stars. I mean, half of the mini stars is way too much. But at least I got it there, so I definitely deserve that for actually just about to actually for those boos little cartment imagery, so oh well.
Finish.
And somehow Waluigi is now in fourth, so he won't able to manage all the dials of the treasure chest, so he won't able to get himself a green Chaos Emerald. Alright, so I'm hoping that I should be able to catch up with this now, so at least I'm now finally going to catch up after the miserable amount of times that I always get caught by boos every now and then. But anyway, and I was like 3 above from Daisy's.
I'm ready.
So ironically, or in this case, thankfully though, we don't have to deal with boos every now and then, so instead we just have to worry about it's the very end. So, at least our sorting goes out well. Well, mainly so. Okay, 4 is now being decreased up to 2 now, so once it gets to 2, things will get a bit easier if you want to actually try to get 2 or higher. Don't go for 1 though, because 1 will actually try to make you go all the way around. Which, if you do that though, that means you won't able to justify if you... You know what though, I might just not get used my dice block just yet. But at least I got a 4, so I'll subtract my 5 mini stars, so. Oh well though. But hey, at least it wasn't as bad as the boos were, because you know. Although, luckily though, in Mario Party 10 though, in the Haunted Trails, rather than just actually getting licked by boo, you lose half of your mini stars. But at least you actually lose 5 mini stars as opposed to half, because thankfully though, the Haunted Trails was as easy as this one is. Although, granted though, forget it though. Anyway, so we have another Bowser event to deal with here. This time, give 10 mini stars to the last place player, assuming Luigi's in this space at least. And he's gonna give it to Waluigi, which, presumably, he's now got 28 mini stars for right now. As for Luigi, yeah, he has like 22, so, yeah. So, yeah, I think there's not much things I just, you know, talk about throughout. So, besides, you know, Mario Tennis Ultra Smash we got until this Friday, and as well as the Falco Amiibo will be on its way too, so, you know. Alright, so... yeah, Waluigi gets his green space, so it's just a, you know, plain one, so, you know. Alright, Daisy, she's gonna get a 3, and she lands on the back space. So I wonder what numbers she's gonna go backwards to. 4. And let's just go back and forth between those both dash and backspaces at the same time. It almost kind of reminds me of how it does it in Toad Road at the very end. But we don't usually do that more often now, so... anyway. Jeez, we're gonna be seeing those a lot of Bowser events throughout this board though every nowadays. But anyways. 5 mini stars to the last place player, so Luigi's in last place, so he will force Daisy to actually give those mini stars to Luigi. So, at least he was trying to actually just to barely catch up to others, though. But I don't guess. I'm guessing my turn will be just about right now, so I should able to manage to make it to the end. Although I didn't care less, because I'm going to use my super dice block anyways just to make it to the end and get this thing over with. Although, not so bad though. But I'm assuming I can just to make it, there we go. So once you get those certain amount of number, if you actually get, if you bust out of this wall, then we can reach into the boss battle in this board. And somehow, it was on the little top of the mini tower. Which is weird. Bit weirder than when you're actually trying to make it all the way to the end in the other boards. Alright, so Bowser, so I'm hoping that we can not able to rematch with Blooper for a third time, but sure enough, it wasn't there. So instead, I'm going to actually fight against King Boo, the actual boss battle in this board. So here we go, King Boo's puzzle attack. Line up 3 or more of the same item to launch an attack on King Boo. Line up lightning bolts for more extra powerful attack. Hold the remote sideways, press D-pad to move the cursor, press 2 to slide an item, then press up and down and left or right on the directional pad when you actually trade for another item. So, yeah. This mini game does remind me of the game called Yoshi's Cookie on the NES, especially on Game Boy. And I'm pretty sure on the Super Nintendo as well, although I may be wrong about that. But this mini game does remind me of that, but except we have to deal with just items, and we have to like just deal with the double amount of food, we have to deal with the damage on King Boo. So that's about it. So, you know. And then if you line up the 3 lightning bolts all together, then you should able to get those bunch of extra points along the way. So I think a lightning bolt will have to be the best one though, because not only you can actually just to get 10 points, but also you're going to let those opponents take away points. So if you're having a really rough time, if you're actually trying to compete those other computer opponents on a higher difficulty, then by all means, just use a lightning bolt just to make it easier time for you. Now, the halfway point of this boss fight is that when you actually deal with the amount of damage to King Boo at the very at least at the halfway point, he'll start to send out a Boo to actually like catch you off guard. And then once you get catch you off guard by the Boo, then you have to shake the wind mug up and down just to break free. So, you know, and somehow Waluigi gets 10 extra points. Just like how it does in the final boss battle in Bowser's Tank Terror Mario Party 10. But hey. Now, unlike the other boss battles, main boss battles at least, and you get like 3 extra points when you actually deal with the final blow. But in this specific minigame, you actually get 10 points while doing the final blow at him. So yeah. Right, so the bonus stars now, so I should able to win now, because every now and then I got a captain bonus as well as I'm in the lead for that boss battle game. Alright, so spin star. I'm guessing Luigi actually got it, yeah, because you know he actually got 1 through 10 dice block item. Minus star mine, because usually I just got lost every single mini stars thanks to that dang booze. But give me some mini stars anyway. Thank you very much. And Dice Block Star, who does that go to? I'm not sure actually. This one goes to both me and Waluigi. Oh, that's quite surprising. So the winner of Boo's Hollow Castle is... Well, if you couldn't tell from that little mini stars count, as soon as we actually get into the results for that right now, Daisy's 4th place. Luigi's in 3rd place. And Waluigi, he's in 2nd place. So I gradually got 65 mini stars. Great job there, Kimmick. You did well though. Even though despite the how many boosts you actually get, countless times you get attacked by it. But I think, apart from those aside, it's a pretty good game though, nonetheless. So, yeah. Wow, Waluigi must have went below before mine. Like, I was really above for like 15 mini stars before Waluigi's had. But yeah, let's have a look at my graph right here, specifically mine. I did pretty well at the beginning though, but later on I seemed to actually get screwed over at some point. Like, you know, these boos that always catches me off guard. But anyways, 108 mini stars actually just about to win those mini games. Jeez, 74 mini stars I actually lost during these events. Well, especially noticeable when there was boos involved. So at least I got the mini stars at least, so thank you. And I got 10 mini stars for that bonus stars count. So yeah, I think we're about to finish this video right here. So next time, let's play Mario Party 9. Is that we're about to be exploring the 4th board called Blooper Beach. So let's have some little relaxation for that part of the trip. So see you guys next time. Later, fellas.